What's up guys, Wally here from Geek.ng. The 10.5-inch iPad Pro is one powerful tablet. Just like the big 12.9-inch model, it has 4GB of random access memory, and for a device running iOS, that's quite a lot of power. I've used a number of iPads in the past, but nothing like this. The A10s Fusion chip on this thing performs greatly, and benchmark results prove this. Apple claims this new line of iPad Pro is going to replace the PC. Is this possible? Well, there's no short answer to this. For someone like me, not really. It might do what my PC does every now and then, but no, it's definitely not going to replace my PC totally. Now let's focus on the good sides first. The 10.5-inch iPad Pro retains the regular iPad design we've been seeing since the iPad here. There is nothing really different here apart from the reduced bezels. A feature I consider great with this design are the four speakers on this thing. For a tablet this thin, the speakers sound really good, but some laptops don't even have this kind of sound quality. There's a 7-megapixel FaceTime camera at the front, a 12-megapixel iSight camera at the back with LED flash. It's the same camera on the iPhone 7. It takes great pictures and you can shoot in 4K. But no, I don't take photos on the iPad. For someone like me, the rear camera is more or less useless. But for those who would want to take photos with a slate, a pretty good camera is what you have on this thing. The 10.5-inch iPad Pro has an amazing display. With a brightness at 600 nits, it's much brighter than all previous generation iPads. It has a pixel resolution of 2,224 by 1,668 and a pixel density of 264 ppi. It comes with a refresh rate of 120 MHz and you can expect very smooth scrolling and pretty fluid constant motion and all. The True Tone display feature automatically adjusts the display based on lighting conditions, so the iPad knows when to make the display appear warm or cold. For graphic artists and photographers, the P3 color gamut support is a much appreciated feature. In short, the 10.5-inch iPad Pro has an amazing display. The iPad Pro has a great battery life. iPads have always been very good at battery management. Depending on the tasks you're running and settings like brightness and background app refresh, you should be able to get up to, say, 8 to 10 hours of use. The A10X Fusion chip plus 4GB of RAM make the iPad Pro a powerful device. The benchmark results are awesome and real-life performance is outstanding. You could run several applications at a time without a problem. I used to have issues opening several tabs on the iPad here too. By the time you check a tab, it's already reloading due to memory issues. This is not a problem on this tablet. Part of this video was edited and put together on the iPad Pro using LumaFusion. Although you won't get desktop level applications on iOS, things are changing and developers are taking advantage of the power the iPad Pro provides. iOS 11 makes using the iPad fun. Features like slide over and split screen increases productivity. The new drag and drop feature introduced on iOS 11 to let you do things faster. Apple is really trying hard to make the iPad Pro a real professional tool, and so far I've been impressed. Now, to my surprise, typing on the smart keyboard isn't as bad as I thought. I could type almost as fast as I can on my MacBook Pro, except for one problem. My fingers keep hitting the screen every now and then. That's the only issue I have with it. Apple Pencil may not really be useful to everyone, but if you take a lot of notes, you might want to buy it. Of course, creatives have no choice. Also, if you do things on your iPad that require precision, I mean the kind of precision that mouse provides, you definitely need the Apple Pencil. You're gonna find it useful. Now, why is the iPad Pro not a real PC replacement for people like me? For a whole week, I tried using the iPad Pro for work, just the iPad Pro. I ditched my MacBook Pro, and well, I was able to do a lot of things with it, but not everything. The iPad Pro is surely a PC replacement for some people. For instance, those using the basic 12-inch MacBook, the iPad Pro with all the power it packs, it does so much for these people. Now, until Apple opens up iOS a little bit further, or until they customize it to really fit the iPad, iOS will remain a mobile operating system holding back this great tablet. Now, you still can't use external storage. I would like to connect my hard drive with this thing and move some files around, but that's not possible. You still can't use peripherals like a mouse. It's not always convenient touching the screen with your fingers and this. I was trying to hide a website to Apple News and Apple claims my iPad is not a PC. For a pro user, the iPad will never replace a PC. Of course, it does a lot of things you would normally do with a PC and it's really powerful. But here is the thing. I'm definitely not going on a trip with my MacBook Pro again. I think the iPad Pro should be able to fill in for it. That's it, guys. If you haven't subscribed yet, please support this channel by hitting the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.